Amit, it was nice to know about your journey, and you very subtly gave differences between, education in India versus education abroad, and what all you learned at both places. So there's a lot of learning that students of today will, kind of get from your conversation. So thank you for that.
My studio is also blessed with my younger brother is a chef, so we have a small hotel just downstairs which serves home cooked food and clean food, which is void of all food colors or anything of that sort. So whenever you come, we can have a nice lunch
Excellent. And
downstairs.
I'm sure
So
this invitation is being extended to all others also who are watching this.
yes, absolutely, absolutely. Yeah.
So Rohit, you've worked on two big films and rather big projects recently. One was Thackeray and one was Bandish Bandits. Of course, you've done a lot more, but we'll talk about experiences as a sound designer that you've done for both.
I'll start with Thackeray, because Thackeray, both these projects are different genres, which is very interesting. Thackeray was a biopic, and a biopic on someone who's always had a larger than life aura and an image. So there was a lot of gatherings, there was a lot of morchas, there was a lot of crowd which we needed to do for Thackeray, apart from the other parts of sound design. So the Thackeray as a film, the first half is in black and white and the second half is in color. So the black and white had was till the formation of Shiv Sena, and that had a different kind of sound design, and the later part had much more elaborate sound
सो
design,
इफ यू कुड टेल अस
a lot of
उससे क्या
ambience.
फर्क पड़ता है, मतलब ब्लैक एंड व्हाइट में भी साउंड अलग होता है ऐसा?
नहीं, हमने अलग रखा, हमने वी दैट वाज माय एंटायर साउंड स्क्रिप्ट. ऑफ कोर्स वी विदाउट कॉम्प्रोमाइजिंग ऑन द इम्पैक्ट, बट दैट वाज अ डिफरेंट बॉम्बे दैट वी ऑल आई हैड नॉट हर्ड, बट आई हैड स्पोक टू अ लॉट ऑफ पीपल एज टू, एंड इट वाज अ लॉट क्वाइटर देन द बॉम्बे ऑफ टुडे. फाइंडिंग अ क्वाइट, लाइक दैट टाइम शिवाजी पार्क वाज अ quiet place. Now it is not as noisy as it is now. So the first part was much about the retro Bombay, the whole art deco and his journey from being a cartoonist to forming Shiv Sena. The second part is all about his morchas, his andolan, the Shiv Sena, the party that was formed. All throughout, we had crowds. There were large crowds. There was VFX on crowds. And to give that impact, very early at the script stage only, I had made my markings as to how many crowd artists I would need. So I had requested them for around 100 and 110. The production kind of okayed around 85 to 90 people. So now the next question was, where can I record all this together? And the only place in Mumbai is YRF. So the main studio at YRF. And we had to do a lot of planning for that, because the way we had set up microphones was we had four U87s, two in the front, two in the back. Then there was a Decca tree. Then there was a sound field surround microphone right at the center of the hall, so that we could get the ambisonics also. So that is how we recorded those crowds, very dynamically, getting all the richness of the Neve, the dynamic range of the microphones, the room, and then with that entire stack. So again, what I didn't do is, usually what they do with crowds is they keep doubling them. Let's do a DT, let's do this. We just took one stack. We never DT'd the crowd, because already with these many microphones and these many people, I knew I would in the post have some phasing issues. I would. So I had decided that there will be no restacking of those layers. I'll just have one pass, rehearse it well with the crowd, with the group, and then have just one pass which of different takes. So there was no DT in the crowd.
So just for the benefit of the viewers, ye 80-100 log jama kaun karta hai?
So we had a crowd dubbing director, Mr. Uday Sabnis, who has been a very active voiceover artist also. And what we did was, through him, we got to different voice coordinators and we got these guys on the roster. There are crowd dubbing coordinators who will manage these amounts of crowds, because for a lot of Hindi films, they usually have that kind of group dubbings.
As a sound designer, do you have to give the brief ki mere ko aged log chahiye, mere ko bacche chahiye? How do you decide that?
Mostly the visuals will give you a fair clue as to what do you want, but in Shiv Sena Sabha, usually there is to be equal number of men and women. But what I did was, I knew that, you know, if I have equal number of men and women, the women will overpower the men when we do a crowd. So I decided that I'll have just 10 women and 60 men. So just to give that flavor of the female sound there and the presence there, I got that. But there was a right sequence also. So we needed kids also, which we dubbed later, which we dubbed at a different studio. So the crowd was absolutely very elaborate on Thackeray. And when we got to the mix stage, Boloi, who has done the mix for Thackeray, had a tough job, you know, getting it to the picture and giving it perspectives.
Right. So what was your role overall? Because a lot of viewers would want to know, okay, so it seems to be like a typical, I would say, a business model, where there is a CEO, a manager, a vice president, a peon, executive. So what was your role in Thackeray, if you could,
So I was the sound designer, and at the same time, I was also supervising the dubs. So I ideally, if you look at the pyramid, the sound designer, and then there is a sound editor who puts out all the effects according to the vision of the sound designer, which is also called track laying. Then there is a Foley artist and a Foley recording engineer who doubles up as a Foley editor also. And all this then comes back to the sound designer in a final mix session, which is then given for a final mix to a re-recording engineer. So there's the dialogues, there's the crowd, there's the ambience, there's the Foley, there's background music. If there are songs, then there are songs. All these are stacked up at the sound designer's end, checked for sync, checked for other discrepancies, and then given to the re-recording engineer for mixing.
Do you have to be present every day, everywhere?
I try to be. Not everywhere, but at least for the dubs. Like, I was throughout for the dubbing of Nawazuddin sir. I was there for his dubbings. I was there for all the crowd dub sessions. I did visit Karan's Foley studio, when he used to finish a reel. So he used to finish a reel, he used to give me a preview, and I used to give him suggestions. And for the mixing, I am there all the time once the premix is done. So once the re-recording engineer is done with his premix, I will usually sit with him for the final mix, and then we'll start giving previews as we finish reels. So maybe we do the first half, or if the director wants to see a reel to just get a direction of where we are heading, then I'll see to it that, I'm ready with that preview, so that, we get a fair idea of what the director is thinking. So yeah, so I try to be for the dubs, most of the dubs. The problem is, if I'm doing multiple projects, then there's a balancing act which I need to do.
Right. So as a sound designer, everything falls on you, basically. Correct?
Yeah, absolutely. creatively, technically, a lot of things need to be kept in mind as to the tone of dialogues. If you're dubbing, if the film has been done sing sound, then that's a complete different ballgame altogether, because then you need to match tones. So Bandish was sing sound. We'll come to that later. And Thackeray was entirely dubbed film. So trying to get that authenticity in dubs and, you know, getting a tonal signature or getting a sound signature for your project is what every sound designer, I think, strives for. And I think everyone has a tonal signature. Every sound designer, if we talk about Idols, then Nakul sir has this amazing sound design tone for his projects. Vishwadeep sir has his own sound signature on every project that he does. So I think it is very unique to each sound designer, and I don't know how to put it in words, but it is something very special to every sound designer, what flavor he gives. So usually my sound editor is Pratik Goswami, who works for me as a sound editor. So me and Pratik will sit down and decide what goes in for each particular scene. So that's how it goes. Yeah,
we also have a lot of clients also and a lot of viewers on the channel who are mix engineers primarily, who are, you know, doing songs or at least want to do that. So usme kya hai ki you are sitting in a room, a dark room, aur aap akele kaam kar rahe ho, raat ko kaam kar rahe ho. As a sound designer, you have to work with various people with various mindsets, correct? So aise mein, as a person, how does one behave differently and what are the plus points one should have in him or her to, you know, kind of do a balancing act, like you said, with different human beings?
Yeah, very good question, Aditya. And I feel there's one word which is, so the way I look at it is, if sound design usually happens at the tail end of a release, okay? If you look at the mindset of a producer or a director, they have been through the whole process of shooting it, editing it, you know, the whole pre-production, and now they are towards it where they know that after this, it's going to be released, or after this, the product will be ready. So kind of there's an anxiety within them ki, okay, ye kab hoga, kaise hoga. So first of all, need to be very compassionate, humble and accommodating, because that is where people will demand, because they want the product to be perfect. So they will say ki, okay, ye dubbing ko aur ek bar karke dekhte, or, you know, you may have to do it a zillion times. So as it is a tail end job, there's a lot of pressure riding on you as a sound designer or as a sound editor to first make it technically perfect, second, creatively perfect, third, collaborate with background score department, collaborate with Foley artists, collaborate with re-recording artists and the direction team, which is overseeing the whole process. So I feel here it is more, you need to be a people's person. You need to be accommodating. You again need to be a very good communicator, because you need to give regular updates. The director will not be there for a tracklist session. He may just hear it at the re-recording stage, but you need to maybe send him a stereo mix. You need to send him, okay, sir, this is the stereo mix of Reel 1 sound effects and Foley mix, you know, with the dialogues, maybe for his reference. You need to take his vision into consideration. Okay, he may not like a certain layer of birds. He may not like too much traffic in a scene. So that needs to be accommodated also. So it's a very challenging kind of situation where it's not just you who are working, because the sound team is a very elaborate team when it comes to a film. Rather, like, unlike a music where there is a music recording engineer and there's a mix engineer and maybe a mastering engineer.
So, Rohit, so basically the role of a sound engineer, like Vishwadeep said in his conversation, is starts at the time of scripting itself.
Absolutely, absolutely. I believe that sound starts at the story, and that's why I usually ask for a script, wherein I then make my own markings and maybe have a chat with the director, telling him my vision and how we want certain treatment for certain scenes. I have mostly in my life I've done thrillers and drama, so. There's a question ki drama film mein kya sound design hoga, but then people forget that dialogue is also a part of sound design. Crowd is also a part of sound design. Your tone of your foley is also a part of sound design. Like, what is your taste? What is the sound signature that you want to give out? So even if you're doing a genre like drama, there is a lot of scope for sound design.
So Rohit, when we buy products today, okay? We check at 3 or 4 websites, ठीक है, हम लोग ये शॉपिंग पोर्टल में देखते हैं, उसमें देखते हैं, और फिर 2 दुकान में भी फ़ोन करके पूछते हैं, भाई तू कितने में देगा, करेक्ट, और फिर जहाँ सबसे ज़्यादा सस्ता लगता है उधर उठा लेते हैं, है ना, कि प्रोडक्ट तो वही है भाई, आईफोन मुझे ख़रीदना है तो मैं 4 दुकान घूमूंगा, फिर जहाँ सबसे ज़्यादा सस्ता डील मिला मैंने उधर ले लिया, राइट. It happens with us also. अरे सर आप इतने में दे रहे हो, Amazon 50 रुपये कम में दे रहा है, यू नो. तो अभी कैसे समझाने का कि भी द वैल्यू वी ब्रिंग पोस्ट सेल और अदर एक्टिविटीज दैट वी डू लाइक दीज कॉन्वर्सेशन एंड अदर इज ऑल्सो अ कॉस्ट टू अस. बट अभी कौन समझाने बैठेगा, 50 रुपये 50 रुपये, अभी यू कॉन्ट, यू नो. सो सिमिलरली वेन डायरेक्टर्स गो और डू शॉपिंग फॉर साउंड डिजाइनर्स.
Yes, 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 they do. And
so what are those kind of conversations you have, ke you are the right person for the job? Bhai, ye koi standard iPhone nahi hai jo har dukaan mein same milta hai. Isme bahut kuch involved hai. So how do you convince them ke
this goes back to a certain director's taste in sound? To be very frank with you, it goes back to their what are their references. So many times someone may come with a reference, or someone may have some reference or past work. So usually I feel a sound designer and a director needs to have a very good creative bonding, you know, a good creative understanding of the process of sound and the application of it as well. Not just knowing the process, but the application of it as well. So when a director comes and maybe there is a conflict or there is a option that he's saying, then it all depends on his taste and your collaboration with him. How much are you ready to, you know, go out and maybe give him that edge that he's looking for, or and share his vision that he is looking for.
Right. So, does budget become a hiccup many times? Ke sir, main to isse kam nahi kar paunga, so aap kisi aur ko dhoond lo.
It does now.
Okay.
It does now.
Okay.
Okay. Because once you deliver, your responsibility definitely widens. It becomes more because I always feel that, you know. Today, everyone can see each other's work. We don't have to wait for releases. It is there online, or, you know. And I think that I'm answerable before anyone to my idols, because they have, again, I'm scared of them. I'm as a creative person, because yeah, I idolize them. So I feel that yes, tomorrow when someone sees that work, it should be that okay, this is done a decent job. So yeah, I mean, budget to aa hi jata hai aajkal ki sir, they come with that, and I feel here we need to make directors aware about, no sir, this is what you've kept aside for sound is way too less. If you really want your movie to stand out, maybe in a theater or on an OTT platform, or you need to, you know, with such good visuals, if you need some good sound, then you will have to spend money. So there have been instances where people have added on to the budget after maybe having a chat with me or, you know, something like that.
No, that's wonderful. So Rohit, let's talk about your recent project, which has been very well appreciated, called Bandish Bandits. So tell us about that.
Yeah, Bandish was a great experience. I feel, again, a musical. So being musically inclined. So now that all those initial years of playing keyboard and, you know, being in a music studio, somewhere I feel Bandish was like deja vu for me and the music. So Bandish started, I got involved pretty early when Bandish was a bound script, and Anand Tiwari was a director. His style is he gets the entire crew together and reads the script, and then we have discussions. So everyone is on the same page with the script and the story and their departments. Bandish had a huge musical content. Shankar Hassan Loy, again, people who I idolize, music composers, they have composed the music, and there are four parts to the music also. There is a playback song, there is a riyaz that happens, there is background score, and there is song performances also. So in all this, the sound is woven. The sound is interlaced with the music. It is not a separate part of the music. So in Bandish, when you watch, you may have the lead character singing or doing a riyaz, and it ends and you hear the ambience around it. It is not separate. It is interwoven. So that was a challenging part. Bandish is one, a sync sound project. So we had different locations, different dialogue tones. Akash Sen Gupta, who's the dialogue editor, has done a fantastic job with the dialogues. So I attend a couple of shoots. The one Sangeet Samrat, which was shot at Bikaner Palace Hotel in Rajasthan, I was there. I was there at one schedule in Mumbai also, wherein. So whenever they used to call me, because I got a call sheet almost every day for every shoot, and whatever days I was available, I used to make it a point to be on set. So being involved in a show of this size and all that was quite overwhelming, and it was very challenging also. So when we started the post, we had our own challenges with Bandish. We had the music team making music. There were constant changes. We had the sound team, which was accommodating those changes. And then, you know, so it took us a time to get to a common page. Common page, I would say, in terms of how we could move ahead in a streamlined way. So the first episode did take time, but once Anand Tiwari had a fair view of what the whole sonic template was or what the sonic signature was, we did find our way, you know. It was quite smooth. So Bandish is shot in Rajasthan and Mumbai, and it has Tamanna's world, it has Radhe's world. So everything needed to have a common acoustics. It needed to have a primer, a sound primer, which we managed to do. And that is why people are liking it. It is an experience. It is not an overcooked sound job. Aditya, just to give you an analogy, I feel sound is like a salt in our food. I feel that, you know, a little bit too much or a little less, and it just stands out. So when it's not observed, or when it's just an experience, I feel it works both for the viewer and the creator, where it's not screaming. कि देखो फुटस्टेप्स का टोन सुनो, देखो वो सुनो, चिड़िया सुनो, देखो एम्बियंस सुनो, नहीं वो जहाँ वो एक एक्सपीरियंस है, जहाँ वो एक व्यूअर को एक टोटल एक्सपीरियंस दे रहा है, दैट इज वेयर आई थिंक द साउंड टीम हैज डन अ प्रीटी डिसेंट जॉब.
Right. So here also you were the sound designer,
Sound
and you
designer
worked in the Thane
again.
studio, or you had to go to different studios?
No, Bandish was done in different studios all over the place. We dubbed at Purple Haze, and we dubbed at Ray and Raga. Then we dubbed also at the AKC Hub, which is a new studio. We dubbed at these three places because Nasir sir's dubbing was done at Purple Haze. Music they were doing at YRF and Purple Haze with music producers. Saumil, who has done the background score, did the music at his studio in Bandra. So Thane was my basic sound design for every episode was done in Thane, but previews all happened at different places. SBM studios we did work at AKC, a lot of work at AKC. So and the final mixes were done at SBM studios and AKC studios, which are primarily 7.1.4 rooms, but Bandish is in 5.1, so it is not in Dolby Atmos for HE project.
Yeah, so your experience in this project, what did you learn? How did your own skills improve after this whole project, kind of got over?
A lot, because as you know, Bandish is an Amazon Prime original. So first of all, you have a spec sheet to follow. All your deliverables need to adhere to the spec sheet. So getting your dynamics and keeping the levels and the experience within the spec sheet. Secondly, I had never delivered such an elaborate MNE for any project. So the whole MNE experience was kind of a learning experience for me and my team. As to now, I know that when I plan projects for OTT or any project, let it be, I'll plan it backwards. I'll plan it from the MNE stage. Especially if it's a musical, it's more challenging to deliver an MNE where your project is going to be localized, maybe in foreign language or in different languages. So great learning experience in terms of working with a great crew and a great cast. I'm blessed that I've worked with Nasiruddin Shah, Atul Kulkarni, Sheba Chadha, Rajesh Telan, of course, Ritwik, Shreya, Anand sir's team, Still and Still Pictures. I mean, it was for the first time I was working with such a professional team. I come from Marathi cinema. They have their own rules, they have their own working patterns, and they're perfect for them. This was totally a different new working pattern for me. So it was good. It was a great learning experience, and I feel it has added on to my skill set a lot, because Bandish was I was we were working on it for a year and a half or so, and this was the first time when the sound team and the music team were collaborating very closely and working. So I had SEL's team providing me songs. I was there for some recordings. I was also closely working with Saumil, who was doing the background score. There were scenes where he has changed the background score to accommodate the sound and maybe make it sound like a. So the sound design is not separate in some scenes, it is a part of the background score.
So, Rohit, thank you for sharing your experiences and learnings from Thackeray and Bandish Bandits. So, as a parting note, if you could share some tips and pointers that those who are looking at a serious career in this field, and many also feel, like you rightly said in the previous part, is you don't have to come to Bombay to, you can create your own market wherever you are. India has a wide variety of music. इट हैज़ लॉट ऑफ रीजनल कंटेंट, तो आपको अपने एरिया में मार्क बनाओ ना, सब भीड़ में आने का क्या ज़रूरत है? So if you could, you know, share some parting notes with the viewers and especially students who can, you know, up their skills from wherever they are, so it will be a great thing, you know, for them.
I feel be open. Once you decide that, okay, you want to do sound, a career in sound, be open to everything. Be open to setting up someone's home theater or tuning someone's car audio or maybe recording a great song or an artist or a podcast or making your own content, mixing songs. Do everything under that gamut. I mean, just don't say, nahi, main toh music hi mix karunga, bhai. Main aur kuch nahi karunga. I'll just do music. Because now it is with all the things happening around us, we need to be accommodating and open to every sort of work within our expertise. So be open to that. Secondly, keep referencing great work done by greats, by idols again. Keep studying that, keep reading about it. I mean, you know, I always hear people ki, arre mere paas kaam nahi hai, main kya karu? Perfect your skills. I'll tell you a story, Aditya, just as I'm taking some time of yours. After Filmfare, I didn't have work for 1.5 years after receiving Filmfare, but I kept doing what I was doing, and I watched a lot of films, I heard a lot of music, I read a lot of books, and then I got Bandish. So, I mean, there's, even if you have a dull time, just look, keep, be positive and keep sharpening your skills. You never know when they may be put to use. So that's it.
Superb. So, Rohit, thank you again for spending time with us.
Thank you so much. Thank you to Sudeep
Audio. Most welcome. Most welcome, and all the very best for your future projects.
Thank you. Thank you.